Greetings for a happy new year 2022. And welcome back to a familiar surrounds of LRC's kitchen. Let's start off with something novel for the year. I have multiple varieties of gooseberry rice, one of which I would present to you today. The requirements or the ingredients, you've seen it on the screen before we started it, but to repeat the obvious, you need gooseberry, you need mustard seeds, some lime juice, some mustard powder, salt, chili powder, I have some turmeric powder and hing. I also have some fenugreek powder. Oil, I use gingerly oil for the dish. I've taken about 6 gooseberries of this size and steamed it in a cooker for approximately 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you'll see that it gives way like this, and then you have to remove them like this. De-seed it . Do away with the seed and cut these pieces into slightly smaller pieces, like you would see I've already cut and kept the rest. You see that the oil is heated up after the mustard seeds slutter. Now add the steamed gooseberry into this. To this I'm going to add some turmeric powder, some hing, mix it in the oil. You will see that it takes in a steady amount of oil. I've used 2 tablespoons, and you remember I've just used about 6 gooseberries. I will now close this for the gooseberry to cook in the oil. I know it's steamed, but to get it a richer feel, it gets cooked for 2 to 3 minutes. You'd see that there's a mild change in the color of the gooseberries. They move from a pale color to a richer yellow. Now I'm going to add salt. Actually, you can put off the stove and add. I'm adding 1 teaspoon of salt. This is salt to taste. It's completely your choice, people. Salt is a habit, it's a cultivated taste. I know people who consume more salt, some people who consume less salt, and there's a new world of people. Back home, I know my own nephew who eats without salt at all. Now, I will add about, again, chili powder to taste. I've used, if you've seen, 2 heaps of a small teaspoon of salt, of chili powder, 1 teaspoon, say, of mustard powder, a tinge of fenugreek powder to this mixture. Mix this well. Ensure that this the spices that you added get completely mixed with the gooseberry. Now, since I'm going to make a rice out of this, I would like to have a little more of the gravy in it, as a consequence of which I'm going to add some more mirchi powder, and therefore an equivalent amount or a proportionate amount of salt to it. My theory is always add a little less salt, because you can always add salt if you find it less in a dish. The converse becomes a greater challenge. Gooseberry has a slight, just a suggestive taste of bitterness, and sometimes it's not sour enough on its individual basis, and therefore I'm adding some lemon juice or lime juice, which is again about, I've added about 1.5 teaspoons of lemon juice to this mixture. Now this mixture is all ready to get to its target, namely plain rice. There's a nice fenugreek mustard aroma to this rice. I'm serving it alongside some banana chips. There's dhania for the dressing. In fact, Datu wanted me to taste it and say it's yummy, but I've gone through these many cooking sites where people compliment themselves by saying what they've made is a brilliant thing. I shall eschew that route. I'd like you to try it out and find out for yourself whether this is a good idea. And I'm not going to hard sell it, except that I'm going to say, do send in your comments and tell us how you liked it. I'll sign off wishing you a very, very, very happy new year and acknowledging Ritika for once trying out the whole dish before we got it for a presentation here, and getting everything in place for me so that I'm ready and just do the shoot. Thank Datu for shooting the entire episode and giving me his valuable ideas here and there, and Abhinav for editing it and reaching out to all of you. Thank you. Have a nice year ahead. Good day.